Davy Crockett's horrible potato story was not the only tragic tale to emerge from the Tallushatchee battlefield. A detachment of Cherokee warriors arrived at the destroyed Creek village in the days after the battle and were moved by the scene.
"We got 20 women and children and brought them to this place, but the greater part of them is badly wounded. We have taken care of them, dressed their wounds, and gave them something to eat." John Lowry, November 7, 1813.
Among the orphan children still alive on the battlefield was a little boy found clinging to the body of his dead mother. A backcountry deerskin trader named James Quarles picked up the child and carried him to Andrew Jackson's camp on the 10 islands of the Coosa River.
He could be unbelievably fierce and cruel. Yes, he was a slave owner. Yes, he was responsible for Indian removal, or the Trail of Tears, that sent, thousands of people far away from their homes, and that thousands died on this long walk to what is now Oklahoma and western Arkansas. Jackson could be a humanitarian, like when he saved a baby off the battlefield at Tallushatchee and nursed that Native American baby and kept it alive and adopted it as his son.
According to the legend, Jackson kept the Native American child alive himself by feeding him a mixture of flour and water. He was given the name Lyncoya by the Pope family of Huntsville, Alabama, that watched over him until he could be taken to Jackson's home at the Hermitage in Nashville, Tennessee. The story of Lyncoya is a complicated chapter in the complicated life of Andrew Jackson. The child grew up as part of the family in the Hermitage, and Jackson referred to him as, quote, "my son." In 1824, he tried to secure an appointment for Lyncoya to the U.S. Military Academy at West Point, but was rebuffed by the administration of President James Monroe.
And Lyncoya later even wrote a letter to Jackson in which he said, "I only want you to see me in as good a light as you see these chiefs who come and visit you to negotiate with you." It's a remarkable letter.
Although some have questioned the authenticity of the letter, there's something about it that rings true. Lyncoya's dreams for himself ended on July 1, 1828, when he died of tuberculosis. He is buried in an unmarked grave. Our series, War of 1812 on the Gulf Coast, will continue at Tallushatchee Battlefield in Calhoun County, Alabama. I'm Rachel Conrad for 2A TV.